Welcome back, and in this part of the course, I want to demonstrate a really simple interaction between the Docker client and the Docker daemon. Now, what we're going to do is use the Docker command line interface to run a sample container. And it's going to be a container called Hello World, which is provided by Docker. And this is going to demonstrate part of the process that's shown on screen now. So we're going to go ahead and download a Docker image. Then we're going to use that Docker image to spin up a container and show you how to interact with that container. So let's go ahead and get started. To do that, we need either the command line or the terminal open, and we're going to use the Docker command. So specifically, we're going to use Docker space run because we're going to run a container. And the container we're going to run is hello-world. Now, before we run this command, we don't currently have any containers or images on our local machine. And I can demonstrate that by running Docker space PS and press enter. And that's going to list any containers running on this Docker host. And as you can see by the fact that we just have this empty line, we don't currently have any containers running. I can also show any Docker images that are downloaded onto this Docker host by running Docker space images. And as you can see, we have none. So this is a clean Docker host. So now I'm going to use Docker space run space hello-world and press enter. Now that that's completed, I want to step through exactly what happened. So I'm going to scroll up. So first, the Docker client tells us that it's unable to find an image hello-world:latest locally. This means that this image is not stored on our Docker host. So hello-world is the name of the image, and then this :latest is a tag, and this just means the latest version of this image. So because it can't find this image locally, it's going to pull this image down to our local machine. So it's going to pull the latest version of hello-world to this Docker host. Then we're told the pull is complete, so this image is now running locally on our Docker host. And then it runs a container using this image, and we get this output, hello from Docker. It also, as part of this hello message, outputs the steps that we used as part of running this container. So it tells us that the Docker client contacted the Docker daemon. The Docker daemon pulled Hello World from Docker Hub. The Docker daemon started a new container from that image, which is running the executable that produces the output that we're currently reading. And then the Docker daemon streamed that output to the Docker client, which sent it to your terminal. So in short, what we've done is pulled an image from Docker Hub to our local Docker host, and we've used that to run a container. Now, you could have pulled the image separately by using Docker pull and then run a container using Docker run. But if you just run Docker run on its own and you don't have a copy of the relevant image, then it pulls that image automatically. So I'm just going to clear the screen to make it easier to see, and then I'm going to run a Docker space PS. And note that we don't see any running containers. And that's because the container that we've just run, all it did was output that text and then stopped. We can run a Docker space PS space hyphen A, and this will show any containers which were previously running. So in this case, we can see that 3 minutes ago, we ran a container with this ID using the hello-world image, and it also exited 3 minutes ago, because remember, all this container did was output the text that we saw on screen and then exit. I'll clear the screen and then run a Docker space images. And this will show us any images which are locally stored on this Docker host. Now, because we didn't have a copy of the hello-world image, when we tried to run a container using this image, it automatically downloaded this image to our local Docker host. And we can see hello-world. Now, this is a really simple interaction between the Docker client, the Docker Daemon and Docker Hub. Don't worry, we're going to go into a lot more depth as we move through the course, but I want you to start off being really comfortable with simple interactions with the Docker Daemon, and that's what I've demonstrated in this part of the course. We've used Docker Run to download an image and run a simple container. We've used Docker PS to list any containers, and we've used Docker PS-A to list all containers, including those which are stopped. We've also used Docker Images to show us any images which have been downloaded to our local Docker host from Docker Hub. Now, at this point, that's everything I wanted to cover in this part of the course. Again, don't worry, we're going to be going into significantly more depth as you move through the course. I just want to start introducing these concepts one by one so we can build on the knowledge as you move through the course. But at this point, that's everything I wanted to cover in this part of the course. Go ahead, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to seeing you in the next part of the course.